The min and max functions in Excel allow you to tell Excel to specify whether you want a minimum of a number of cells or the maximum of a number of cells. However, there's something that needs to be understood about these functions. What you have here is a very simple spreadsheet. There's a reserve requirement, and then there's a cash available. And the min is used to decide which is the minimum, and that is how much is kept aside. So, for example, when you have 90 available, that's the most you can put behind, but you need 100, and so it goes on. And at this stage, you no longer require a reserve. You've got a cash available, but you don't need to hold it in a separate account. What's important to know that when there's a zero here, this calculation is getting it correct. However, if this was deleted, and the reason this is mentioned is because people often associate empty cell with a zero. So, for example, someone might say, well, let me highlight these two and delete them because they're not required. What happens is Excel ignores these empty cells and says, well, the minimum is now here. It's the 130. And this can cause problems in certain spreadsheets. So you just have to be careful to make sure that no empty cells are causing problems in your min and max features.